I feel the earth move under my feet.
My name is Russ Kunkel, and I had the great honor to be able to play on the Carole King album Tapestry as a drummer and percussionist. The feeling in the room while recording Tapestry at A&M Studio B was pretty magic, actually. It was magic because Carole really knows what she wants and what she likes, and she also knows what she wants and doesn't like. And fortunately for me, the songs that I got to play on and the things that I chose to play, she liked. Between Lou Adler's production style, which is hands-on, but also he lets the artist, you know, shape the music that they're going to shape, and Carole's, you know, divine musical expertise, it was truly magical. Carole would come out with lead sheets and chord charts and lyric sheets and pass them around, and she would probably sit down at the piano and play the song once through by herself and kind of sing it just to show us the song. And I would make notes on my chart based on, you know, as the song was going down, things that I thought that I wanted to notate on my chart to make sure I knew where certain things happened. When we would cut the track, I don't think that she would sing a guide vocal. That's why she would sit down and play it for us by herself, so we knew kind of what the gist of it was. But she would play the piano part, and then you know, we'd do takes until we got one that Lou wanted us to come in and hear. One of the many things that contributed to the Tapestry album sounding as intimate as it sounds is that Lou Adler is a great producer, was and still is, and he knows to not get in the way of what's already great. And Carole sitting down at a piano and singing a song, you know, is great on its own. And all that has to be done is just enhance it and put some things around it to lift it up and to hold it in certain places. And that's exactly what Lou and Carole did. It was intimate, and the songs were intimate. So when the songs are intimate, the arrangements need to be intimate. Music that was made during that period of time was made by real musicians all in one room playing together at the same time. And that's why it sounds like it sounds. You know, there's no plug-in for that sound. Tapestry broke the glass ceiling, certainly for female singer-songwriters, and let everyone know, put the world on notice that you can do this. This can be done. And you can have album of the year and song of the year and record of the year and artist of the year all in the same Christmas stocking. Now that it's 50 years later and you look back on it, I remember when Tapestry went to number one, and it was like it was the longest record at number one for I don't know how many months or years. When we reached those points, you could look back and you could go, wow, that was a cool thing to be a part of. That was great to be a part of that history. And I just want to say to everyone, and certainly to Carole, that you deserve every single accolade that could possibly be given to you. And you are truly one of our treasures. And we are so blessed and so fortunate to have you and have your music and have your light with us on this planet. Thank you, Carole.